After so many years of research on Waldenström disease, which are the main progresses and discoveries?
So the main progresses and discoveries in Waldenström has been the understanding of the genome for this cancer. This came because whole genome sequencing was finally a technology that we were able to use to be able to investigate the cause of Waldenström's macroglobulinemia. And we were very fortunate because this technology allowed us to detect some very important mutations. The first one is the mutation in the MYD88 gene, which about 95% of patients with Waldenström's have. This mutation actually allows the cells to grow and survive. And it also, you know, allows us to understand why the disease is able to grow and give us new targets for therapy. The other important discovery was a second gene, and this is the CXCR4 gene. We find it in about 40% of all patients. And this is also a very important gene because it explains why the differences in the disease occur, why some patients have very high IgM and they present with problems with the IgM. And so what is exciting here too is that this is also a mutation that we can actually develop drugs against, therapeutics against.
Which are the most recent news about the drug therapies for Waldenström?
So the most recent discoveries for new drug therapy involve the work that was done with these mutations, the MYD88 mutation in particular, and this led to the discovery of the drug ibrutinib. This is a drug that blocks BTK, which is turned on by the MYD88 mutation. And over 95% of patients have the MYD88 mutation, so this is why it's exciting that a drug like ibrutinib can actually shut down the pathway that allows for the Waldenström cells to grow and survive. Now, this is the beginning of many, many new drugs that will come because of the genomic discoveries. There are also other drugs like ibrutinib that are currently in clinical trial, and I expect that many of them will be approved. But we also have the opportunity to make drugs against the CXCR4 mutated protein, which is found in about 40% of all Waldenström's patients. There is currently a clinical trial, which we are running now, using a drug that's able to shut down CXCR4. In addition, the drug venetoclax, which actually blocks a protein called BCL2. This is a protein that allows the cells, the Waldenström cells, to grow and survive. You can actually give drugs to these cells, but they won't die, and it's because of BCL2. But we now have this very exciting new drug called venetoclax that actually shuts down BCL2 and allows the other drugs to do their work.
Which is the next goal you want to reach to cure Waldenström patients?
Well, looking at our strategies towards curing Waldenström's, I think it's important now to take everything that we've learned about how these cells grow and survive, and being able to now rationally target these different pathways is what the work we're doing in Boston is all about. Ibrutinib finally gave us a drug that is able to shut down MYD88. Venetoclax is a drug that can actually shut down BCL2. This is actually the protein that blocks the ability of ibrutinib to work. And now what we're very excited about is that each drug actually is active, but if we can put them together, we now have a rational way about shutting down the ability of the Waldenström cells to grow and survive.
Could you suggest a certain kind of lifestyle for Waldenström patients?
I'm often asked about the lifestyle. You know, what is the correct lifestyle for a patient with Waldenström's? I think the most important thing for patients to remember is that they need to go on living. And that means to take care of themselves and to, you know, avoid things that can cause other problems, like smoking, which can cause, you know, heart problems or other cancers. To stay on top of your screening, you know, whether it's colonoscopies, checking your skin for cancers, you know, having the routine maintenance, that's very important. And that's because survival in Waldenström's has increased dramatically now with all the new drugs.
And the last question, please, can you give a message to Waldenström patients?
The message I want to give to Waldenström's patients is that things are changing very rapidly, and all for the better. When we look at survival in this disease, it has increased dramatically. And this is something we can get very excited about because it was really the community of patients that came together working with their doctors to make all the important discoveries to allow us to understand the genomic changes that are responsible for the disease, to help understand which were the critical pathways that allow the cells to grow and survive, and more importantly, for patients to have participated in the clinical trials that made all the progress possible. And today we now have our first ever approved drug specifically for Waldenstrom's, and I really think this is the beginning, the first chapter of a very long book, one that ends with a cure.
Thank you very much, Steve.
Thank you.